I am claiming that this is my hand, this is my leg, this is my ear. Even children says, ask the children, what is this? It is my hand. But we may claim, but actually it is not our hand, it is given. Because I wanted to use my hands in so many ways, Krishna has given all lives. You take this hand, use it. So it is gift of Krishna. Therefore, a sane man is always conscious that whatever I have got in my possession, first of all this body and senses, they are actually not mine. I have given all these possessions for utility. So if ultimately everything belongs to Krishna, why it is not utilized for Krishna? That is Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness. That is intelligence. If I am given all these things for my use, for my sense gratification, but ultimately it belongs to Krishna, everyone is part and parcel of Krishna. So everyone's senses are also Krishna's. So when these senses are utilized for Krishna's service, that is perfection of life. And so long it is utilized for my sense gratification, it is Maya. Therefore, bhakti means Rishikena Rishikesa Sevananga Bhakti Ruchat. Rishikena, by the senses, this Rishikesa, Sevanam, when you serve Rishikesa, really master of the senses, that is called bhakti. A very simple description, definition of bhakti. Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam. Rishikesa Sevanam. Not Rishik Sevanam. Rishik means senses. So, when senses are used for sense gratification, that is Maya. And when senses are used for the gratification of the master of the senses, that is called bhakti. Very simple definition. Anyone can understand. So, generally, in this material world, everyone is using the senses for sense gratification. That's all. That is their bondage. That is Maya, illusion. And when he comes to Krishna consciousness, purified, when he understands that actually these senses are meant for satisfying Krishna, then he is liberated person. Mukta, mukta purush, liberated person. Iha jasya harir dasya karmana manasa bhacha. When one comes to this position, that my senses are meant for serving the master of the senses, Rishikesha. The master of the senses is sitting within your heart. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishta. I am seated in everyone's heart. Matta smriti jnanam apohananj. From me, remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness is coming. So, why that? Because Krishna is so merciful. If I want to use my senses in a certain way, not my senses, it is Krishna's given. So Krishna gives the chance, all right, utilize it. Suppose I have got tongue. If I want, Krishna, I want to eat stool. I want to test too. Yes, Krishna will say, yes, you can take this body of hog and eat stool. The master is there, Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, matta smriti jnanam apaharanj. He gives you the body, reminds you, my dear living entity, you wanted to eat stool, now you have got a proper body. Now utilize, here is stool also. Similarly, if you want to become demigod, that also Krishna gives you chance. Anything. There are 8,400,000 forms of life. If you want to engage your senses in any type of body, Krishna is giving you, come on, here is the body you take. But we become exasperated by using our senses. Ultimately we become senseless. Therefore Krishna said, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam śaraṇam. Don't do like this. Your senses are meant for serving me. So you are misusing it. By misusing, you are being entrapped in different types of body. Therefore, to get relief from this tedious business of accepting one body and giving it up, again another body, anything like that, to continue this material existence, if you give up this process of sense gratification and surrender unto me, then you are saved. This is Krishna consciousness.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.